and then yeah.
They warm up to get used to the range to make sure they know what arrows are going.
So this is Patrick on target one versus Michael on target two.
Nice bright string from Patrick.
Yep.
Michael is another fellow thumber. Is he using it today?
I can't tell.
And these guys will shoot together quite a lot. They're training together at the moment.
Yeah, he's thumbing.
Yeah, he's thumbing.
Of course, the wind is.
I know Patrick is looking to make the leap of thumb soon after the Worlds. He's in the group chat, if you like.
He
is high and right.
Which can change the flight of the arrow slowly.
You can see the old temperature and the wind there. So the wind is deceptively light on that, I think.
Yeah.
Certainly feeling it a lot more than you were seeing it.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, of course, the archers will need to adjust their sights and...
Okay, so I'll take this opportunity to talk about the guys and their path to the finals then. So Patrick got through, he only shot three of the stages, but that was enough. He did a first place at stage four, he did a third place at stage three, and a seventh place at stage five. And Michael Judd qualified in sixth with a third place at stage five, a fifth place at stage two, and sixth at both stage three and six.
Yep. So Helen's just asked what we mean by the thumb. So as you anchor, some people like to have their thumb going down their jawline, whereas an alternative is to have it wrapped around the tendon in your neck, which some people find gives them better alignment. It's down to personal preference, but I think a lot of people have decided to switch to it this year, hence the hype about it.
If you have a look at when Michael is shooting, you might, if the camera angle is switched, you might just be able to see his thumb tucking behind that tendon, and you'll see exactly what I'm on about. You'll certainly see Alex doing it again in the next round.
And the judge for this match is Aaron Sandstein.
Okay, so now we're doing it for real.
Michael on.
Both of these archers are on the national squad. So,
and they both shoot Hoyt.
They both shoot Hoyt, yeah.
And I've just got a text from a friend of mine across there. What wins?
Who's shooting first? Ranked higher.
Well, you're on the struggle sticks,
so Patrick ranked higher, so he can choose. And he's let Michael go first.
Yeah, the decision as to where he shoots is purely psychological. Just down to whether you want the other person to have to shoot the first arrow or not.
Nine.
Good opening.
Yeah.
I know Patrick's been very confident with his shooting recently. I asked him how he was preparing for this competition, and Patrick, he likes the psychological game quite a lot.
Yeah.
So he spent Saturday night watching himself win previous medals. So that's good little confidence boost before going into the finals, I suppose. I wonder what Connor's writing down in the background there. It's Patrick's coach in the box, if you like.
I think he's probably writing down his arrow values so he can work out his averages.
Oh, it looks like he's got a target there. He might be plotting them.
Yeah, he might be doing that, actually.
No.
See, at this kind of level, it's all about those small margins. So, obviously, if his group's very slightly high, moving his sight, just a couple of clicks and it'll bring them more central. Which is, I guess, is what he's plotting them for. Ready for the next match, assuming he gets through.
Nine.
So, Patrick wins that first set, 27-24.
Well, 27-24 in favour of Patrick on target one means that he will take a two-set lead. But of course, lots of arrows to come yet, so as we've seen in previous matches, that can change. So do we get everybody out there? You all right to cheer and shout? Support the Archers? Every arrow that goes down, you can't shout and go, woohoo! And other such whoops of delight. Not only is it allowed, it's compulsory. Here you go, second set. Michael shooting first on target two.
Second set. Michael's up first.
Mike.
It's a strong shot, that is just out.
Yeah, Patrick's wearing his famous flat cap today.
Yep.
Became a little bit of a symbol for him in Rio, didn't it?
Yeah.
Mike.
Mike with his Hoyt flat, with his cap as well, Hoyt cap. He wears that a lot. Sun's just gone behind some clouds.
Ten.
There we go.
It's good grouping.
Really good
there.
Group there, yeah.
Nine.
That's it, moving his sight there. Both arrows to the left. Ten size group though.
Bit of a shaky bow arm there.
Seven.
Ah. Yeah.
See a disappointment with that.
Ten.
That's it. That's what you want. Nice 28 from Patrick.
So once again, 28.
Yes, like I said, they work a lot on making sure that average isn't below 27. So it'll be surprising to see Patrick's average to be below 27, and I mean I think Michael's just had a couple of bad arrows, but besides that I think he's doing alright.
So I met Patrick on two of the stages in head-to-head, and he was really on form. So I think it was both days in Surrey we met each other in the head-to-heads. He just whitewashed me, man. He was 28, 29, 30. It was just really, really good to shoot with someone of that level.
Yeah, it's nice to shoot with someone that's got a lot of experience that kind of rubs off on you a bit.
Yeah, it was really good. He's really helpful. Helps push you.
Nine.
It's very unusual for Michael to shoot sevens.
Yeah. I shot with Michael in the ranking round in Bronte and he was shooting really well.
Right.
I looked a bit surprised for that shot.
Sometimes a shot goes off and you just don't expect it to.
Ten.
Good shot.
Nine.
Nice response. So Patrick should be able to seal this, six or above, for the match.
Ten.
Classic bit of steering there, but he got it.
So Patrick's going to move on to the semi-finals.
As they always say, let's wait. For Gareth down the far end to confirm the scores with the scoring team.
That's another cracking string of results from Patrick there. So that's Patrick, Keith and Alex all scoring 27, 28, 29. All right up there.
Yeah, it's going to be a tough year this year, I think. So the next match is between Jack Masefield and Ash Morgan.
Conservation. Pat Easton takes the match.
There we go. Now he can watch that match for his next matches in Mexico.
We can watch that match for the next one coming up.
That's it. He's going to have a lot of